Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. In this episode, we need to talk about C++ 23's amazing new range formatting capability. Before I continue, I do need to point out a few things. The first is that I am currently having to use a trunk build of Clang. And I have it in a very recent version of C++. I have C++ 26 at the moment. And on Compiler Explorer here, I have to specifically specify libc++. I need this to use Clang's standard library. I also need to take the opportunity to point out that I am available for code reviews and on-site training. And if you have not had me out to your company for on-site training, you should do that. This episode is sponsored by JetBrains. Today we need tools that help us work quickly and effectively. CLion is a powerful JetBrains IDE for C and C++ that makes filling this need its main goal, integrating code analysis, refactorings, and a wide range of tools into your day-to-day development. The latest version of CLion introduces deep integrations with the ReSharper C++, Writer C++ language engine, performance improvements for the debugger, new features for embedded development, and enhancements for project models and build tools. Use the code CPPWeeklyCLion to get 25% off when purchasing a new CLion subscription or renewing your existing one. This thing has many layers to it, and it comes down to a whole lot of new standard formatter specializations that were added in C++ 23, and our standard libraries are starting to get support for these things. I can now print a pair, which on its surface might sound like a simple thing, but the compiler has to determine at compile time if the things are things that it knows how to print inside said pair. There are formatting strings available for these container-like things. The rabbit hole does not go as deep as I would like it to, but you can see down here that this was a parenthesized thing. And now that I did this colon M, it has printed it more like a key value map pair. And that will be important in a moment. I can also print tuples, and pairs are tuple-like things, so this really shouldn't be terribly surprising. The compiler does try to be smart about these things. If I say that I want to print this as a key value map-like pair with that colon M formatting again, I'm going to get a compile time error because this only works with things that have two elements in them. I can also do other formatting things that remove the parentheses or the delimiters around the thing. I don't have quite as much flexibility here as I think that I want, but I also might not fully understand the depth of what's available. I am relying heavily on CTAD, class template argument deduction here, if you're not familiar with this. So on line 9, I have asked for a vector containing the values 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The compiler is going to deduce that that is a vector of int for me. The line above it, I've created a tuple of 1, 2, 3, hello world. And that is going to be a tuple that is int, 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 const car pointer. And you can see here that I've got this vector properly printed and it's now in brackets. It's not a pair or a tuple-like thing, so it's using brackets instead of parentheses. But again, I can kind of modify these things a little bit if I were so inclined. There are also other options for specifying the delimiter between the elements and a bunch of other things. Again, we're not going to go down that road at the moment. This can print any range-like thing. So I can go so far as to create an array and then drop a couple of elements or filter those elements or whatever else sounds interesting to me, and it will do that and then print the remaining range. You're probably now already asking, but can it do things like a pair of vectors or a vector of pairs? And the answer is yes, it can in fact do that. we have some flexibility to specify how the innermost thing is formatted. So I should be able to say that this last thing should now be printed as a vector of key value pairs by doing this colon colon m thing. And that worked. But I can't ever get it to go deeper than two colons, and I'm not entirely sure why. Because if I have a greatly nested thing, like the next thing I'm going to go ahead and paste into here because it was a bit of a pain to create in the first place when I was working on these examples, I can have something like this. This is a map of strings to pairs of ints and maps of time points to vectors of ints. And I need to include a handful of additional headers to get this to compile because we do not have standard module support yet. And there you have it. This is my map, which had the value hello, which had a couple of other values in it, and then this timestamp, which was itself a key, into another map that had a vector with the values 1, 2, 3, 4 in it. And it did the proper thing all the way down, and I will fully admit that this was in fact rather slow to compile. But it's very interesting, and I feel like this is very dangerously close to being able to do something like JSON serialization quite easily. Pair this with a little bit of potential C++ 26 reflection support, and, well, the limit is just your imagination. I hope you enjoyed this. This is all real. This is C++ 23. You can use this today on some compilers, so go ahead and check out the example and the description that I have in the notes below this episode. And thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. Be sure to subscribe and share your own thoughts about using this.